Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jones.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. Say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jellin. Yesterday, Ali sent in a question about how we can make a chart automatically expand as we type new data in, and I used a dynamic named range yesterday. Now, just quickly, you know, one way to do this is not automatically, but fairly easy to do. If you click on the chart, you can see the blue outline around the data. Just grab that lower right handle, and you can add the new data to the right hand side. So that's one method. But the other method that is available in Excel 2003 or Excel 2007 is where we use either the list function in 2003 or the table function in 2007. Now, this top left cell here, I'm going to type a value there, like label or something like that, so we have headings above everything. In 2003, you would use Control+L. In 2007, we use Control+T. My table has headers, that's good. Click OK. And now we've defined a table for that range. And the amazing thing about this table is as we add new data, so if I come here and type week 7 and type a value, you see that the chart automatically updates. So the chart was based on the table. We add new data to the right side of the table and the chart automatically updates. So a great way to go without having to worry about using the dynamic named ranges and so on. Just set up a table, Control+T. Back in Excel 2003, it was Control+L. Back in Excel 2002, you have to watch yesterday's podcast to use the dynamic named ranges, and you can solve that problem. So I want to thank Ali for sending that question in. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.